Welcome to another SiteGround video. My name is Cal Evans. In this video, we're going to look at 15 steps that you can take to make your WordPress site more secure. Let's begin. Security is everybody's job, from your developer to your system administrator to your hosting partner to you. Everybody has a role to play in keeping your website secure. Now, as the site owner, there are several things that you can do yourself to help ensure the security of your site. Let's talk about a few of them, shall we? The number one thing that you can do to make sure that your website is as secure as possible is to make sure that you have a hosting partner that has a reputation for security. If you don't build your site on a rock-solid foundation, everything else we do is for naught. There are a lot of good top-tier hosting partners out there for you to choose from. I've personally hosted with a good number of them, and I can honestly say that I've never found one better than SiteGround. SiteGround's infrastructure is rock solid, and the few times I've actually had to call and contact their support, they were responsive and friendly. If you have concerns about your hosting partner, stop this video now. Go deal with that first. Talk to them. Ask them what they do to keep your site secure. If you're not happy with the answer, start searching around for a better option. Once you have your site hosted with a solid and secure hosting partner, then come back and watch the rest of this video. I can't tell you the number of times I've given site owners this one piece of advice. Make sure that your WordPress core, all of your plugins, and all of your themes are updated. Now, these days, WordPress makes that pretty easy with the auto updater. Even so, when I log into one of my sites and I see that there are updates, I go ahead and take the extra minute and manually update them just so I get any bug fixes and new features that much faster. Also, if you've got plugins and themes installed that you aren't using, delete them. Don't just deactivate them. Go ahead and remove them from your site totally. If you think you're going to use them later, great, install them back later. For now though, if it's deactivated, delete it. PHP is the engine that powers most of WordPress. It's the language that the majority of WordPress is written in. New versions of PHP are released on a regular basis to fix bugs and security vulnerabilities. It's important that you run your site on the latest version of PHP to make sure it is as secure as possible. Thankfully, most top-tier web hosts give you the option to on their control panel to select which version of PHP you're running. These options usually have all the current versions as well as an automatic or managed option. This allows your hosting partner to upgrade PHP for you whenever a new version is released. If you know for a fact that you have a plugin or theme that will not run on the latest version of PHP, then manually select the highest version you can in order to run your code. Then, immediately contact the author of that plugin or theme, or bring in your own developer to get a solution that works. You don't want to be held back by bad code. It should really go without saying at this point, but if you've not installed a secure certificate on your website, stop this video now and go do that. A secure certificate protects your users because it encrypts the conversation between the browser and your server. Now, thanks to Let's Encrypt, secure certificates are free for everyone. Most top-tier hosts now allow you to request and install one automatically right from the web control panel. If you're hosting with SiteGround, go to your site tools, select security, SSL manager, and then choose between the type of certificate you'd like to install, and then click install. If you already have a certificate that you want to import onto your site, you can use the import feature to import that one. Once you're satisfied that your hosting partner is working for you to keep your site safe, it's time to do a little of the work yourself. There are a lot of good security plugins out there in the WordPress ecosystem. Some of them are simple and do a couple of things very well. Other ones are complex and require an annual subscription to use. You need to figure out what's important to you, and that will dictate which plugin you use. For me, the free SiteGround security plugin is the first plugin I install every time I set up a new website. Even if that site's not hosted on SiteGround, I still install it because none of the features require a SiteGround account to use. Getting this plugin installed is the first step in keeping the bad actors out of your site. The next few sections all revolve around properly setting up this plugin. Two-factor authentication, or 2FA, is an added step in the process that helps keep bad actors out of your site. Using a device, usually your cell phone, you enter a code after your login and password. If the code is valid, then you're allowed in. 2FA codes are usually time-sensitive codes. If you use a tool like Google Authenticator on your cell phone, the codes for each website change every 30 seconds. This keeps people from being able to guess them or capture them and use them over and over again. SiteGround's security plugin makes it simple to turn on 2FA for all of your admins. Since 2FA is an extra step that introduces friction for the average user, I don't recommend it turning on for everyone. On the other hand, I strongly recommend that you require it for every admin on your site. There have been many attacks against all kinds of software that relied on the fact that the first account that anyone ever creates is named admin. If a bad actor only has to guess two pieces of information, and you have an account on your system named admin, well, you've just given them half of what they need to access your site. Now, these days, WordPress asks you what the name of the first account should be during setup. If your setup was controlled by your hosting partner's control panel, then they probably used your email address or your control panel name for that. No matter how or when your site was set up, make sure that your site doesn't have an account named admin. If you do, or if you're unsure, the SiteGround security plugin will help you change it to something more difficult to guess. A lot of attacks that are tried boil down to what we call a brute force attack. This means that a bad actor runs a script that tries different logins and passwords on your site. They may try 5 or 10 per minute, or they may try hundreds per minute. No matter how fast they're trying, if you detect a brute force attack, you need to act quickly. One way to do this is to limit the number of failed login attempts for any given account before you lock that account. One way to do that is to limit the number of login failures you allow for a given account before locking that account. If an attacker is trying different passwords for a valid login and you limit the number of failures to 5, then after 5 attempts, that account is locked. Yes, this means that even the account owner can't log in for a while, but the bad actor now has to move on to a different account or even a different site. I recommend turning this feature of the SiteGround security plugin on and limiting failed attempts to no more than 5. Any legitimate account owner will either remember their password or click forgot password before hitting 5. Another thing that you can do to prevent bad actors from accessing your website in ways that you don't want them to is to limit the IP addresses that can access your admin site of your website. If you don't have regular users that access your website and your IP address is fairly stable, then this is a good layer to add on top of the other things that you're doing. Warning: if your IP address changes regularly, and most home internet connections do, or you regularly access your website from your phone, then this option will cause you more problems than it's worth. Also, if you have users that regularly log into your site, this is not an option you want to enable. Still, if you want to enable it, it's easy with the SiteGround Security plugin. Just log into your website, go to the SiteGround Security plugin menu, and click Login Security. There, you'll find a Configure button next to the Limit Login Access. And when you click it, a box will pop up. In that box, you enter your IP address. This will whitelist your IP address. This means that it's the only IP address that you will be able to use to log in and visit the admin side of your website. Use this option with care. You can easily lock yourself out of your own site if you misconfigure it. Most of the time, and by most, I mean 99.99% of the time, the files that make up the WordPress core never need to be changed. Operating systems allow you to lock files so they can't be written to, only read and executed. This prevents anyone from maliciously overwriting your files with their own. Back before we had automated tools to handle upgrades and such, I used to have scripts that would do this for me every time a new version of WordPress came out. These were scripts that I wrote and scripts I had to maintain. Now, with automated tools, these things are mostly done for you. To make sure, though, tools like the SiteGround Security plugin will do this for you. Not only will it lock the files for writing, but it double checks to make sure that your web server is properly configured so that it can't accidentally allow someone to execute random code. Security is all about layers, and this one is one more layer that you can put on top of your website to keep it secure. For a long time, XML-RPC was a useful tool that allowed other programs to communicate with WordPress. Those days are fading into history now. These days, all of the functionality that XML-RPC provided is handled by the built-in REST API. If you're interested in knowing more about the REST API, check out our free ebooks on the topic. You can download them from a link in the description below. Now, even though it's not used anymore, XML-RPC is still hanging around in the source code. Those who get nostalgic about such things see it and smile. Those who worry about security see it and frown. It's easy to disable XML-RPC. Using the SiteGround Security plugin, you just go to the SiteGround Security plugin and disable it with a click. Then you don't have to worry about it anymore. DOS and DDoS stand for Denial of Service and Distributed Denial of Service. They're very similar ways to attack a WordPress website. Basically, the only difference is, in a DOS attack, one computer is attacking you. In a DDoS attack, many computers are attacking you. The end result, though, is both the same. Your web server gets more requests than it can handle, and it starts to slow down to the point where it eventually doesn't serve any pages at all. And that's the point of a denial of service attack, to stop your web server from serving pages. DOS attacks are pretty easy to stop. You simply block the IP address of the machine that's attacking you, and it's over. DDoS attacks are more difficult, sometimes much more difficult, to stop. DDoS attacks usually come from networks of computers called botnets. A botnet may have 1,000 computers in it. And instead of one computer making 1,000 requests to your site, it can have 1,000 computers make one request to your site. Since they're spread out over many machines, it's really hard to tell an attack from just regular traffic. Top-tier web hosts have DDoS mitigation systems built into their infrastructure, such as SiteGround. If you're unsure if yours does, contact customer service and ask them. The bad news is that if you get hit by a DDoS attack, there's not much that you personally can do because the tools to stop this operate at a level that you are not allowed at. The good news is they work well enough so that you really don't have to do anything. They're all automatic. In computer systems, there is a concept of the principle of least privilege. For WordPress site managers, the concept is simple. Only give users an admin role when they absolutely must have it, and limit these to as few people as possible. When you hire a new employee or bring on a new contractor, give them an account with the absolute minimum privilege they need to get the job done. If later on you decide that they need more privilege, you can escalate them and give them more access to do their job. But remember to de-escalate them when they're done. Also, remember to deactivate and remove any account of any employee or contractor who's no longer working for you. Don't leave these accounts laying around inactive, as they're just ticking time bombs. As a site owner, you should be doing regular backups of your website. Now, most top-tier web hosts have an automated system that will back your entire site up, files and database, and store it for you. How much you pay for this service usually determines how long the backups are stored for or how often you can create them. Check with your hosting provider. You want at least 30 days of backups stored for you. At SiteGround, for example, with any of their hosting accounts, you get free daily backups stored for the last 30 days. And in addition, on their higher plans, you have the option to create on-demand backups as part of the plan. Furthermore, you should download one backup each week to a local computer and store it for at least 6 months. This gives you long-term backups. If your site gets compromised and you don't notice it right away, you're going to want to be able to go back 30 days to find a clean copy to restore from. If you don't notice it within that first 30 days, well, you've got bigger problems than this. But if you're storing backups locally for 6 months, again, you've got options. Backups are not enough, though. You need to document, test, and practice restoring your site from a backup. If you haven't tested your backups, you don't have a disaster recovery plan, you have a lucky rabbit's foot. Once a quarter, take a backup, restore it to make sure everything is working properly. If it can't be restored, work with your hosting partner or your programmer to find the problem and fix it immediately. Finally, if you've done all the rest, one final layer of security you can put on your site is to move your login page to another URL. Since almost all WordPress sites are standard installs, bad actors depend on your login page being at wp-login.php. You can thwart them by moving this page, at least for a little bit. Now, don't just move it, that's going to break a lot of stuff. You need to use a plugin to properly configure everything to work with the new location. Thankfully, SiteGround's security plugin will do this for you automatically. Just click the configure button and follow the prompts. Once you're done, the next time you log in, it will be at the new URL. Don't forget it though, because WordPress won't automatically redirect you. That wouldn't make a lot of sense, would it? As I said in the beginning, security is everyone's responsibility. In this video, I've given you 15 things that you can do to help make your site more secure. No one of these things by itself is going to make your site that much more secure. Put together though, layer upon layer, they will help make your site more secure. Secure enough so that it's easier to move on to the next potential victim rather than try to continue to crack your site. Hopefully for their sake, the next site owners watch this video as well. Hey, I want to thank you for watching this video today. I hope you found it informative and useful. If you like this video, click the subscribe button below and hit the bell icon. This way, we'll let you know anytime new videos are released. Also, follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram to stay up to date with all the news happening around SiteGround. We'll see you on the next video.